Hi friends,
welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. As you know, this is the second part of the series Cozy Den. Yet again, here you will get to see how with such simple elementary things, you can effortlessly revamp any tricky space of your house and shift gears from dull monotonicity to an interesting one full of character. What? You are on a budget? Then this is the perfect place to be hanging in for a while now to know home decor doesn't always need splurging. Easy and quick DIYs can do wonders as well in creating a soothing, dreamy ambience in our home. This is just the continuation of the first video, so you'll see more new ideas for adding unique focal points in our house with a cushy ambience to be in clover. Of course, who doesn't want to feel luxurious? Make use of your free time in building something productive, which can be therapeutic as well. If you haven't watched the first part yet, do check out the link above or in the description box as well to give more structure to your ideas and to know how it all started from scratch. So let's get started with the detailed process for the first one, pine cones. As in the pine cones will lantern. You need pine cones, of course. I have been collecting these dry pine cones along the sidewalks while I go for jog and evening walks, and few from my backyard, for which my husband do pull my leg as if I'm a rag picker who keeps picking up waste from roadside, even though I convince him it's all about frugal lifestyle, honey. What's the harm in getting something absolutely free for which people spend a lot to buy from stores, and it's helping environment as well. A win-win situation. But as usual, he turns a deaf ear to my logical and frugal explanation. Never mind. And yeah, please excuse my peeled cuticle. Maybe due to dehydration from excessive hand washing. Anyways, not relevant for now. Once I got them in varying sizes, I painted with these acrylic colors, copper, silver, golden, white, to complement with other decor pieces using a simple brush. You can paint just the borders. Isn't it a beauty to adore? Make sure even the bottom is well painted. Of course, these little ones are no less. When it's done with white, you just can't help but appreciate the well-defined contrast it creates. You can even paint the insides to give it a complete golden ornamental look. And as I prefer a natural, organic, raw look, so on few, I did an unfinished work with some of the natural pine peeking through. Along with these at home, I had few other fillers, some of which I made long back from floral foam ball by gluing decorative feathers, and few I bought from stores. Keep filling up the glass lantern with all these fillers. Adjust the look you want to go for according to your preference. Used these battery operated LED fairy string lights, two of these, to add the glow component. To be honest with you guys, for this one, to complement the brown of pine cones, I had planned to keep the natural brown woody side of the log to be on top, as in to be seen, the one I showed you all in the previous video. But so sorry, it just slipped my mind. Not that this tint of white side is not making it look cohesive, just that, as I mentioned you earlier, thought would let you know in case you wonder for which decor I use that brown side. For the branches, we saw in the previous video, one other variation is by adding this white string lights. Just twirl at the base of the vase to add the glow from down. To get that soothing, dreamy ambience with twinkling stars effect, here's another way to enhance these branches. Use these two battery-operated LED microfairy string lights copper wire, warm white glow in copper and silver color. As it's made of copper, it is easy to bend and wrap around the upper half of branches, which would be above the vase height and visible outside. Silver would blend well with the white color of the branches, but I had only one of the same, so I even used the copper ones which I had spare at home. But anyways, as they are so fine in thickness, it won't be an obvious eyesore. While it has a flickering setup resembling twinkling stars, the silver is the constant one. With two string lights, I try to cover up as many branches as possible. Once everything is set and well lit up, looks so quixotic, such an utopian vibe. Doesn't it feel like snuggling up next to its warmth? Perfect ambience to pep up our mood during this lockdown. I'm sure it will be a conversation starter for your guests and of course after the lockdown. And no one would leave your house without complimenting. I'm not just saying because it's my creativity, but literally, I can say being the experienced one. I get so many compliments because of this that now I can vouch for its worth. Hope you like my creativity, and in case you try any of these or this video helped you in any way, don't forget to let me know in the comment section below. There's a lot of hard work put in. Please acknowledge by like and sub if you haven't already. And stay tuned for more decor ideas in my coming videos of this series. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.